Come on in, like and share. Love and share. God bless you. Come on in, like and share. God bless you, Ranita. Come on in, like and share. Please share this. God bless you, First Lady. God bless you, Miss Charlene. God bless you. Come on in, like and share this, like and share. Let's get these numbers up, like and share. Come on in the room, like and share this, like and share this. God bless you, Brother Youngblood. Let's like and share this broadcast tonight. We're not gonna be long. Hallelujah. Come on in, like and share, like and share. Come on in the room, like and share this. God bless you. Let us know you're here. Praise God. Praise the Lord. We bring you greetings tonight from the pastor's study, Mount Calvary Community Church. I am your servant leader, and I am proud to announce as of Friday, I was elected by the people, by you, to be your pastor. And we are elated to serve and build God's kingdom here on earth at the Mount Calvary Community Church. We are located at 5112 Ames Avenue in the beautiful city of Omaha, Nebraska. We are the biggest little church in Omaha. Come on in and like and share this. Let's get these numbers up. Like and share. Like and share this. Please take some time to go to our website, www.m3comaha.org. God bless you, Sister Jamie. It's so good to have you on tonight. www.m3comaha.org, and that's our website. You can also use that facility to send a donation, sow a seed, and you may also do the same on your Cash App. That's right. You can take your cell phone, your mobile device, go to your Cash App, and it's $M3C5112, $M3C5112. Tyrone Bolton, God bless you, man. I praise the Lord for you. Amen. I praise the Lord for you. Thank God for you. The other week, we were talking about, not last week. Last week was dedicated to Chadwick Boseman, but we spoke about WAP. And our WAP was not the WAP that Cardi B and whatever the other child name is. We're not talking about their WAP. Praise the Lord. But we were talking about worship and praise. And tonight I want to do a WAP part two, but this time, instead of talking about worship and praise, I want to talk about money. I want to talk just a little bit about money, but about wealth more so, and prosperity. Wealth and prosperity. Come on, like and share this. Get these numbers up. The numbers were up and they dropped it. Y'all done dropped out. Get these numbers back up. We want to talk about wealth and prosperity on tonight. Wealth and prosperity, WAP. I tagged a text in the post earlier from Proverbs, the 11th chapter, and I'll begin reading there. We're talking about wealth and prosperity tonight. The 11th chapter of Proverbs, the 24th verse, and I'm reading. Let me go up and go to the 23rd verse, and I'll read down from there. And I'm reading from the God's Word translation. And it says, come on, like and share this, like and share this, like and share this, like and share this. Get these numbers up, and I'll get out your hair. Praise the Lord. I got some homework to do tonight. I got to go. I'm in school, so we got to do a little reading tonight. So we won't be long. So let's get these numbers up. Let's hit it and quit. Praise God. Amen. All right, so Proverbs 11th chapter, 23rd verse, the desire of righteous people ends only in good. The desire of righteous people ends only in good. But the hope of wicked people ends only in fury. Verse 24. One person spends freely and yet grows richer. I'll read that again. One person spends freely and yet grows richer, while another holds back what he owes and yet grows poorer. King James Version says it like this. For those who don't like the God's Word translation, you got to have that thou, thus, and stuff. It says in the King James, there is that scattereth and yet increaseth, and there is that which holdeth more than is meet, but it tendeth to poverty. What the Word is saying, there are people who spend freely. My wife is a spend freely person. She spends freely, yet grows richer. And then there are some of you who will hold on, even when you owe the money, even when you have it to pay, you'll hold on to it, you'll hoard it, trying to keep on holding on to what you have. And in the process of trying to hold on to what you have, the Bible says that I didn't, you grow poorer. You lose trying to hold on to it. When you give it freely, you increase. Let me read further. Verse 25, a generous person, this is God's Word translation, the 11th chapter of Proverbs, the 25th verse, a generous person, God bless you, Sister Bessie, a generous person will be made rich. Rewind the tape. A generous person, a person who is generous, will be made rich. And whoever satisfies others will himself be satisfied. Lord, I love you. People will curse the one, this is verse 26, I just said this, who hoards grain, but a blessing will be upon the head of the one who sells it. It's not good for you to just have stuff laying around. You better have a garage sale and get rid of that stuff and make some money on the stuff that you have and let it bless you. God bless you, Kwame. God bless you, man. It's so good to see you on tonight. Praise the Lord. Come on in, like and share this, like and share this. Kwame, like and share this on your Facebook so all your friends and your loved ones can see what's going on at the mount. People will curse the ones who hoards grain, but a blessing will be upon the head of the one who sells it. Whoever eagerly seeks good searches for goodwill, but whoever looks for evil finds it. You have to be careful, people of God, in the area of wealth and prosperity. I'm going to give you some tools, just six little things, maybe seven, that should bless you on tonight. Now, what is wealth? Wealth refers to the state of being rich, or having an abundance of material assets and money. That's being wealthy. The state of being rich, having an abundance of material stuff and money. Money does help. The Bible says money answers all things. You need money. I know it says the love of money is the root of all evil. Yes, but you got to have some money to answer everything that needs to be answered in your life. Praise God. What is prosperity? Prosperity refers to the state of having an abundance of material assets and money. Yes, so money is all about a part of being prosperous. But there's some other contributing factors to prosperity, like good health. Y'all ain't talking to me in this chat room. Happiness. Being prosperous is, in addition to having money, it's also having good health. It's also, aside from having good health, it's also having happiness. Our founding Bishop William Frank Taylor had an expression, and it was, "Are you happy? If not, why not?" Bishop, I can't find happiness in my life. If you've been listening to me for these last 12 months, I'm going to tell you, you can think yourself to be happy. You can think happiness into your existence, right? 3 John, the second chapter says, "Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper, comma, and be in health, even as thy soul prosper." Beloved, I say it again. This is 3 John, second chapter, second verse. I wish above all things. This is Paul talking to the church. I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. So having prosperity also speaks to your health. It speaks to your happiness. It speaks to your state of being. It's beyond your assets. It's beyond your money. But how do you increase yourself? I'll read it again from Proverbs, the 11th chapter. A person who spends freely grows rich. And yet another holds back what he owes, and he grows poor. A generous person will be made rich, and whoever satisfies others, himself will be satisfied. Do you take the time to be a blessing to the people that you see? Do you take the time to be a blessing to the people in your family? Or do you hide and hoard? There was a man, I'm not hating on him. He won a Mega Million, a Powerball or something or other. And when he goes to collect his money, for fear that his family would ask him, he didn't say anything about his friends. He didn't mention anything about his neighbors. But he said, in case my family asked me for anything, what he did, he, Tyrone, he goes to a Halloween shop, and he gets a mask, and he receives his check with a mask on to conceal his identity. Are you trying to conceal who you are? God bless you, Apostle Hopkins. Are you trying to conceal that God has blessed you? Are you trying to hold it for a rainy day? You know, it rained yesterday and it rained a little bit today. Are you holding on to it? When you give it freely, the Bible says a generous person will be made rich. If you spend freely, you grow richer. This is Proverbs, the 11th chapter, 24th verse. And another holds back what he owes and yet grows poor. We're talking about, you just tuned in, we're talking real quickly about wealth and prosperity. Wealth and prosperity. Now, let me give you these, few nuggets about wealth and prosperity. First thing I want you to understand, on your road to being wealthy and prosperous, you ought to put that in the chat box. I'm going to be wealthy. I'm going to be prosperous. I'm going to be wealthy. I'm going to be prosperous. You don't have to put the and. I'm going to be wealthy. I'm going to be prosperous. Now, the first thing I want you to understand, you might want to write this down. You have to know what it is that you want. You have to know what it is that you want. You have to set your affection towards that very thing. Because prosperity, understand, beloved, does not come by accident. It's a choice of dedication and commitment. Praise God, Brandon Chambers, my son. Dedication and a commitment to the very thing that you want. So you have to truly know. God bless you, Andrew. You have to truly know what you want. And then put your request out for the Lord to hear it. Oh, I think I'm in Habakkuk. You have to put it out there that he that runs with it can read it. If you can formulate the question, you'll get an answer. So focus on what you do want. Do not focus on what you don't want. Because the law of prosperity and the law of attraction does not have a bias about your negative and your positive. The law of attraction brings back to you everything that's in your spirit. So don't focus on the stuff that you don't want. Only focus on the things that you do want. God bless you, Sister Gunn. God bless you, Shanika McFall. Focus on what you want. Don't focus on what you don't want. And it's a habitual thing to go to the negative, that what if. What if this? What if that? What if I lose my money on this deal? What if I fail? What if I can't afford it? And all these things come into your spirit and they terrorize you and you can't sleep at night. You have to focus on the thing that you want from the Lord. I'm talking about wealth and prosperity. Wealth and prosperity. I told you the other month, we brought it here with us. There's a money tree, but I went and got a new pot for it. And I repotted it. And that thing is a money plant. And I go speak to that money plant. I had some stuff obstructing my pathway to the plant. So I had to find me another route. And I go to that plant and I say, good morning, money. Good morning, money. You are welcome in here. Soon as I said that this morning, I come to check my email. I told my wife I need to get better time management with school. And trying to prepare lessons to preach and teach from. I need to get better time management because I have I have OCD. I don't like, if I get 10 emails, I need to get my emails down to nothing. I don't know if y'all like that or not. It might just be me. My mother and my wife, they got 2,599 emails just sitting there wasting away. I like to get emails out the way and get down to nothing. And so I checked my emails and I got about 7-8 accounts. So I'm checking all of my accounts under. And so I get to my one Lord, I didn't even tell my wife this. And so I got an email that there's a check coming. And I got nervous because it was unexpected. Now it's my money. You seen that commercial? It's my money and I need it now. It's my money. I was not expecting this money. And so when I go to the plant, I say, money, you're welcome here. Come sit down right in this very seat. Check my email. And it says, Kevin, there's a check being sent to you. I check my, and then I go to the account to check it to see, because I didn't order it. And then I didn't finish reading the email. It said, now, if you did not request this, it's because you have been vested. And because you've been vested and it reached a certain amount, we're going to issue you a check. And then I got nervous. I said, Lord, did I change and update my address and let them know I lived in Omaha? I don't live in Southfield, Michigan no more. And so my heart started racing and I started to panic just for 5 seconds. And so, Lord, thank you. Lord, I 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 thank you. Because money is welcome here. My aunt back in Detroit, the assistant pastor of my church, the Temple of St. Jude, where I'm a member, the church that I attend, she would always say at offering time, there is money circulating all around me right now. So the first thing, you got to know what it is you want. Know what it is that you want. Number two, let me get out your way. Number two, you have to live with expectation. Expect to have an abundance. Expect to have a harvest. Wishing and hoping and affirmations. I love affirmations. And prayers don't work unless you believe. I've been saying for the last 12 months, and I've said it longer than that, but you only know me 12 months for sure. The words that I speak are my law of good. They will produce the desired results because they are operated on a power greater than I am. And that's true. But these affirmations that I'm speaking to you will not work unless you believe that it's going to happen to you. You have to expect a harvest. You have to expect abundance. It was raining, and when the mailman come down the street, and I look out and I see that little truck go down the thing and come back around again, I go right to the box. Now I don't know sometimes, and I get the informed delivery, but then there's sometimes that'll be mail in the box that did not make it to the website to show us that something was coming. So we always go expecting. Just in case the informed delivery didn't catch it. I'm expecting something to come. There used to be an old affirmation. Somebody from somewhere is going to send me some money today. You have to live with an expectation of something that you want. So know what you want and then expect it to happen. Know what you want and then expect it to happen. Come on, like and share this. Like and share this. Let's get these numbers up. Let's get these numbers up. Know what it is that you want and expect it to happen. Number three, act inspired. Move with conviction. Let me say that again. Act inspired. Move with conviction. Only take actions that you are inspired to do. Don't go about what you read in the book, about what somebody else did and how they got theirs. You have to be inspired and ask the Holy Spirit to give you something. Act inspired and move with convictions. And if you try to do all the things that you read about and all the stuff that somebody else did, you're going to miss a step. Lord, unfold my understanding so that I know what I want. I'm living with expectation, and expecting means you know it's going to happen. I don't know when, but I know it's going to happen. I don't know where, but I know it's going to happen. I don't know how, but I know it's going to happen. Somebody shout, I know it's going to happen. And then after you know it's going to happen, you have to act inspired. Move with conviction. This morning I'm getting dressed. First lady said, where you going? To the office, across the hall. Because I was inspired this morning to get dressed. Put a little jewelry on. Early this morning, I didn't leave the door except to go to the mailbox. You have to act inspired. Move with conviction. What do you want to do? And if it feels irresponsible to do what you want, consider a different perspective. Because it is your responsibility, beloved, to make yourself happy. God bless you, Reverend Moore. God bless you, Bishop Teal. It is your responsibility. It is not my responsibility. It's not your spouse's responsibility. It is your responsibility to make yourself happy. And when you're in the flow of joy and peace, which surpasses all understanding, everything you attract will please you. Lord, I love 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 you. Now, here's the fourth key. I promise this right here gonna bless you. This is the fourth step. This is the fourth key on your way to being wealthy and prosperous. Number four. Let's rehearse. Let's rehearse the list, and then I'm gonna give you number four. So number one, know what it is that you want. Live with expectation. Expect it to happen. Act inspired. This is number three. And move with conviction. And number four, this gonna bless you. Oh, it's gonna bless you. Mind your business. That's my mic drop. It is your job to mind your business. I hear you, my uncle, Reverend Gerard Duncan. My business is my business until I tell somebody. It is your job to mind your own business. And your business is knowing what it is and what isn't making you happy. What's not making me happy about this investment? What's not making me happy about this partnership? What's not making me happy about this job that I go to? What's not making me happy about the task that I'm involved in? If it's not giving you what you want, you have to change it. But you have to mind your business. God bless you, brother. My brother Malcolm is on the line. I cannot focus on what's going on next door and expecting to receive an abundance of harvest in my own life. If I go up and down whatever the name of this street is, 128th Circle, and seeing what's going on over on this house, and what's going on at this house, and what's going on at the house across the street, crossing the church, the house in the circle, and the house up the street, the house in the other circle, then I'm not minding my own business, and I'm not asking God for what I want because I'm minding y'all business. I'm not living with expectation because I'm expecting to see something at your house. I'm not acting inspired because there's no way I can be at your house minding your business and still getting inspiration from God that way. You have to mind your business. Come on here, Pope O'Neill. And sometimes, I'm going to throw this one in for free, you got to shut your mouth and save your soul. Everybody don't need to know your playbook. Y'all hear me? All right. All right. Praise God. God bless you, Andrea. Number five. That thing made me happy right there about minding your business. I've been waiting to say that one all day. number five. Listen to your inner you. Your inner you is that still small voice from God. Anytime a deal or a situation, a circumstance, come on, Jada Pickett, an entanglement has gone sour, you know something wasn't right from the beginning. There's something down in your spirit. Something ain't right. My grandmama said, you got to have some discernment. You have to discern in your spirit. And when that still small voice said, you better listen to the voice of God that's speaking to you, that's giving you direction. And then when you think about it, you look back at that situation, it's like, God told me. Ooh, he told me. And you get happy all by yourself because the Lord be done told you. And you say, I thank God I heard his voice. And not only did I hear his voice, I heeded what he said to me. Lord, I love you. And sometimes when they say it's too good to be true, it is too good to be true. Brother Jamar, God bless you tonight. When something is too good to be true, be careful. I would say something else, but I don't want to get in trouble tonight with the, So be careful. Your intuition will give you a simple and a short message. Y'all be looking for that, the thunder to roll and the lightning to strike and flash. And you want to see a storm and like, you know, God shake my bed, shake me. You don't want none of that to happen to you. That would frighten the hell out of you. And you know it. I was just reading, studying for school in Numbers, and God says to Moses, listen, you and Aaron done made me mad in the few chapters before. Y'all done made me mad. So listen, I'm telling you now, you ain't going to the promised land. I'm telling you now, you gonna die before they go to the promised land. This is what the Lord says to Moses. Now, he don't say die like that, but you know, you catch the drift of it. You ain't gonna make it. And when they get to, he writes a letter trying to go through from Kadesh to through Edom. And Edom said, no, y'all ain't coming through here. And so he goes another way and they find themselves on Mount Hor. And when they get to Mount Hor, God says, Moses, come up here. Bring Aaron with you. Okay, God. And so he goes and he said, and bring Aaron's son too. Okay, come on, Aaron. Come on, Eleazar. This is Aaron's son, and they go up to the mountain. And God says, take off of all of Aaron's garments. And he strips Aaron. He takes off of his priestly robe. And he takes the robe that was on Aaron, and he places it on his son, Eleazar. Eleazar. And Aaron falls dead. Y'all want to have a good sign like that? That would terrify you. And so when Moses and Eleazar come down from the mountain, the Israelites, they're looking at the mountain. They say, well, there's Moses. There's Aaron's son. I don't see Aaron because Aaron had died. Sometimes you don't need to see something so dramatic like that. There's a still small voice in you. And sometimes it's better to play it safe when that voice speaks to you than to be sorry. Lord, I love you. 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 Here's the sixth thing. And I'm gonna get out your way. Remember, and I said this word earlier, remember the law of attraction. Remember the law of attraction. It takes the same amount of effort to create $1 million as it does to create a dollar. Let me rewind the tape. It takes the same amount of effort to create $1 million as it is to take to create $1. If you knew you could create $1 million a week, you could. I hear you, Granddaddy. Bishop Posey said, if you would just work together as a church, people tell us Temple of St. Jude this all the time. If y'all would just work together and stop working against each other, if y'all would just come in here and worship God in spirit and in truth for real, if the lights went out in Detroit, that would be enough energy in Temple of St. Jude to light up the entire street where the church sat, where we wouldn't be in darkness. If we would stop fighting with one another in Mount Calvary, we could speak to yonder's mountains, and the mountain will get out of our way. Because it takes the same amount of effort to create $1 million as it is to create a dollar. It is the same process to manifest any dollar amount that it is that you want or you desire. You desire it. You decide you're going to have it. You've taken an inspired action. Now you believe it. And when I believe it, it'll show up. It'll manifest in my life. You, beloved, can have abundant prosperity right now. And it does not matter what you have created in your past, because your past is what has happened in your yesterday. Yesterday is gone. But abundance right now is available to everyone in the same amount. And if you believe that tonight, I want you to just type that. I believe it. And whether you do or don't is the very reason why you have prosperity. Because watch this. I'm not saying you're not prosperous, but whether you do or don't is the very reason why you have prosperity to the degree and the level you desire or not. One person, this is Proverbs 11, spends freely and grows richer. Another holds back what he owes and grows poorer. A generous person will be made rich. Whoever satisfies others, himself will be satisfied. So again, you have to know what it is you want. God bless you, Sister Quintain. Know what it is that you want. Live with the expectation. Some kind of way, it's gonna happen. I don't know who, I don't know when, I don't know. I just do know that it's gonna happen. Act inspired. Move and walk with conviction. Walk with purpose. Mind your business. Oh, Lord, I love you. Mind your business. Listen. Number five, listen to that voice of God that's in you. Your discernment. All I'll be saying, it's in my shando. Oh, it's down there. You got to listen to that voice of God. Listen to your inner voice. And then remember the law of attraction. And remember, as I said earlier, the law of attraction does not have any bias. All it does is attract the very thing that's in your spirit. So don't focus on the stuff that you don't want. Don't focus on the stuff that you don't need. Only focus on the thing that it is that you desire from God, because the law of attraction will bring it to you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. It'll bring it to you. In the midst of a pandemic, I looked yesterday on Facebook and my cousins, my one cousin is a realtor and my other cousins bought a house. In the midst of a pandemic, we have members of our church who've been blessed with new homes in a pandemic, because you have to know what it is that you want. You have to live in expectation. You have to act inspired. You have to mind your business. You have to listen to that small voice and allow the law of attraction. The words that I speak are my law of good, and they will produce because they are operating on a power greater than I am. Member called me, and we had access to a program, and they were behind in their rent. I'm not saying who it was. Don't you worry about that. They were behind in their rent, and they didn't qualify for the program. But God, they didn't qualify for the government program or for the agency's program, but they qualified for the favor of God. And so while they were behind on the rent, the Lord said, "Listen, let me help you out. Let me throw this one in here for you. Let me bless you with this." God says, "I'm going to not only catch you up on your rent, I'm going to pay your rent through the rest of the year." Because the law of attraction will bring to you the thing that you desire. And if you're not careful, it'll bring the things that you don't desire because you still focus on the negative. It takes the same amount of effort to create $1 million as it is to create a dollar. The words that I speak, they are my law of good. They will produce the desired results because they are operated on a power greater than I am. Good alone goes from me. Watch this. You should know this by now. And then, because only good goes from me, the only thing that can come back to me is good. And so good returns to me. And yeah, I love you. I'm concerned about you. But this word right here is personal. This is for myself. Everything that I'm saying right now is for myself and about myself. A generous person will be made rich. And whoever satisfies others, himself will be satisfied. Won't you take some time to be a blessing to someone? Sow a seed into someone's life. Be a helping hand. Stop hoarding stuff. It's fall. I know we have spring cleaning. You should do a fall cleaning. Just go through your house and just start getting rid of stuff and make room. And when you make room, God can begin to fill in those voids. Praise the Lord. When you make room. And how many of you need to make room right now for God to move in your life and make room for him to move not only in your life, but in the life of your family? I need him to make room and give him access and give him a free course to do what it is that he needs to do in my life. Because of myself, I can do nothing. But with God, all things are possible. I need you to sow a seed tonight on this word. I need you to go as many people as can to go to your Cash App and sow a $25 seed to the Mount Calvary Community Church. That's a Cash App, $M3C5112, $M3C5112. If you're going to sow a seed tonight, type in the chat room so I know that you're sowing. I'm praying a special prayer for you, for those of you who sold that $25 seed tonight. If you're sowing that seed, just type in sow. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. Let me type myself. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. Praise the Lord. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I'm sowing. I can't type fast enough. Praise the Lord. I'm sowing. If you're sowing that seed tonight, I'm sowing. Type in there, I'm sowing. I'm asking as many as can to type I'm sowing and to sow that seed on this word tonight. $25, M3C5112. You see mine there. I'm sowing. $25, M3C5112. $M3C5112. This Saturday at 10 a.m. on, I believe, this same station, we are having leadership meeting. We're in our fifth installment, meeting God's enablement for all believers. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. For those of you who are sowing tonight, God bless you tonight. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you tonight. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. That's $M3C5112. Or you can go to our website at www.m3comaha.org. www.m3comaha.org. Know what you want. Live with expectation. Walk in expectation. Act inspired. Move with conviction. Mind your business. Listen to the voice of God. And remember the law of attraction. Father, I thank you. I give you all the praise and glory for these people of God who've tuned in tonight. We ask, God, that you move mightily all through the lives of your people at the Mount Calvary Community Church, the biggest little church right here in Omaha. We pray, oh God, that you would give abundance and give prosperity to the people of God. We give you praise and glory throughout ceaseless ages. In Jesus' name. God bless you. The Lord bless you. The Lord bless you. I'm sowing my seed. God bless you. God bless you, Reverend Moore.